Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be creating guitar vector design using Illustrator and Photoshop. We'll be using 3D Extrude and Bevel option to get the perspective look and clipping mask option to apply texture. So let's begin with the designing process. Open a new Illustrator document and draw a circle using the ellipse tool. Then click and drag to create a duplicate with the Alt pressed and slightly increase its size. Here we must check the proportion and gap for proper shape. Now make a copy for the right side and make one more copy for the left side. Make sure that the two circles are intersecting with the other shapes. Now select all the shapes and using the shape builder tool, extract out the middle region. This will give us the basic shape of the guitar. Delete out the remaining pieces. Next, select the pen tool and delete out these four anchor points. Then using the die selection tool, adjust the handles to get a pointed corner. Adjust the tangents to get a smooth, curvy guitar shape. Do the same for the other side. Next, we're gonna be giving the perspective depth. So to give that effect, select the shape and go to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel option. This will open the Extrude and Bevel attributes. And here, adjust the perspective angle. Then increase the extrude depth value to give a decent thickness to the design. Also, adjust the angle of rotation. Set the perspective angle to 60 degree, Z value to minus 4 degree, Y value to 22 degree, X value to 29 degree, and the extrude depth value to around 100 points. Then click OK. This will give us a nice 3D guitar body. Next, we'll expand the shape, so select the shape and go to Object and apply Expand Appearance. Then ungroup it twice. This will leave us all the separate pieces. Next, select all the shapes from the right side with the Shift pressed, then apply Unite option on the Pathfinder. This will convert it into single object. Now select these particular shapes and delete out the remaining part. Now select the shape and apply red color with the help of our picker tool. Next, to get these curved stroke lines, select the pen tool and draw a curve. Give it a stroke color. Now, create another duplicate of the curve and using a die selection tool, start adjusting the shape of both lines. Adjust the handles until the flow matches with the guitar curve. Then change the stroke color to white. After this, select both the strokes and under Stroke panel, change the profile to this. Click on this icon to flip the direction. Edit the curve path with the die selection tool. Next, change the stroke thickness to 3 point. After that, select both the strokes and using the blend tool, click on the first curve, then on the second curve. This will add blend steps in between. To adjust the number of steps, double click on the blend option. Then switch on preview. Here select specify steps, put the value 3 and click OK. Now we got a bunch of 5 stroke path with equal gapping in between. Next, we'll follow the same steps and draw out 2 curves for the middle part and 2 more curves for the top. After that, select the top 2 curves and go to stroke panel. Here increase the size and change the profile to pointed corners. Next, repeat the same method for the middle part curves. Select both the curves, then using the blend tool, click on the first curve, then on the second curve. This will create a blend of 5 curves. Now select the top 2 curve paths and apply the same effect. Next, select the top 2 curve paths and apply expand appearance to convert it into fill object. Repeat the same procedure for the middle curves and for the bottom curves. This will convert all the curve path to fill object. Next, select the body shape and the fill curve path and apply minus friend option on the pathfinder. Again, select the body shape and the other curve paths and apply minus front. By doing this, we got a body shape with the path shapes extracted out. Next, select these two shapes and click on unite. This will convert the whole design into singular shape. Next, you can see here the shape is non-curvy, so we'll delete a few of the anchor points using the pen tool. Then use the die selection tool, edge the handles to give a smooth curve. After that, to get this middle string part, select the rectangle tool and create outer rectangle. Then apply fill color from the color swatches and edge the width and height. Now create a copy of the rectangle and drag it down. Reduce its width and height and place it around here. Next, create two more duplicates of the shape and place them one beside the other with equal gaps between them. We'll increase the height a little bit more. Then using the pen tool, add two anchor points in the middle of the first shape. Now using the die selection tool, drag this anchor point to a right side to reduce the thickness of the top region. Then using the pen tool, delete out the top anchor point. Let's delete out the other two shapes and instead of that, create two duplicates of this modified shape. Place them with equal gapping. Next, select all the three shapes and click on Unite option. Now select the rectangle and the united shapes and apply minus front option to subtract the top shape. This way, we are left with single object. Next, draw a circle using the ellipse tool and place it beside the rectangle. Now using the pen tool, draw a path joining the rectangle box and the circle in order to give a particular shape. Edge the handles and the vertices to give a smooth finishing. Next, select all the three shapes and unite them. Then using the rectangle tool, create out one at the bottom. After that, make a copy of your previous shape and give a stroke color. For this, give a stroke thickness around 3 points. Then arrange it to front. Now go to Object, Path, Outline Stroke to convert the stroke to fill object. Then apply Unite option on the Pathfinder. After that, select all the shapes and click on minus front. This will leave us a rectangle shape with a parallel gaps. Now place it to its original position and change its color. Next, draw a circle from the middle of the rectangle and switch the fill color to stroke. Then under Stroke panel, activate Align Stroke Inside and increase the stroke thickness to 24 points. Now arrange it to back. Next, we'll add a background color, so draw a rectangle same size of the artboard and apply light gray color to it. Then arrange it to back. Now select the circular shape and change the stroke color to white. After that, select all the three shapes and go to Effect 3D Revolve. Then under 3D Revolve panel, edge the angle of rotation. Here, if you notice, each shapes are rotating in its own axis. So before applying the revolve option, group them up using the keyboard shortcut Command or Control G. Now under attribute panel, set the x-axis to 28, y-axis to 26, z-axis to 0, and the perspective value around 0 degree. After that, check out the size and proportion of the middle parts according to perspective view. After adjusting the shapes, select the rectangular shape and apply dark blue color. Next, to give a 3D feel to your design, draw out a sharp curvy shape using the pen tool. Then, next to that, draw an under shape according to the guitar angle. Edge the handles to give a nice curve near the contact. Next, we'll add texture and shade to design. So select our guitar vector design and drag and drop it to a new Photoshop document. Scale up the size and place it around here. Now I have got a paper texture image. We'll use it to add texture to our design. So drag and drop it to our main document file, scale on the size using the transform option and place it on top layer. Next, make a selection of the guitar layer by clicking on the thumbnail with the alt pressed. Then selecting our texture layer, click on mask option to mask out the texture layer. Now if you see, our design color is changed. To edit that, add a new black and white adjustment layer. Then click on that place when it shows down arrow icon to apply clipping mask to the texture layer. Now go to properties and edit the red color slider to edit the texture detail. Also reduce the fill value of the texture layer to around 60%. Next, I'm going to use some brush strokes to give some style to your design. So let's drag in this brush texture to our document. To remove the white background, select the magic wand tool and click on white color to make a selection. Then click on vector mask to hide out the selected area. Now group the layer using the keyboard shortcut Command or Control G. Now place the brush strokes over our design, and with the control pressed, click on the thumbnail of the guitar layer. This will make a selection. Then click on the vector mask. To make the texture move independently, press unlock. And change the layer mode to overlay. This will add a nice shade to design. Next, create one more duplicate of the brush layer and move it to the top region. Reduce the fill value to around 46%. Next, type our text, type the number 81 and give a suitable font. Next, take a copy of the text layer and type out musical. Reduce its size and apply red color by picking the color using the eye picker tool. Then give a suitable font style. Now select all the layer except the background layer and the text layer and group them up. After that, make a copy of the group and scale up its size. Place it to give a look of a cover page. Reduce the size of the number and do the overall adjustments as per your requirement. Lastly, we'll change the color of the background. We're going to change it to bright color. So double click on the background layer to open the layer style panel and activate color overlay. Here under color picker, choose cream color and click OK. This will add a nice fresh tone to our design. Finally, we have completed designing a musical guitar vector. During the process, we have seen few new techniques which can be applied to create unique design. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.